Good evening, everyone. So the keynote speaker for today's session is Dr. T.K. Mishra. So sorry. He's the Vice Principal of Ramanujan College and the Director of School of Happiness. The topic for today's session is Spiritual Values for Happiness, Part 4. Over to you, sir.
Well, thank you, Sanskriti. Let me begin with what a Persian Sufi, Jalaluddin Rumi, way back in 1300 BC, he said that whenever you ask for happiness, you are actually knocking from inside. He said that I knocked and the door opened. I knocked and the door opened, and I realized that I was knocking from within. Well, I would also like to mention Mahatma Gandhi in this regard. Mahatma Gandhi, what he said about God. He said, God is conscience. God is that indefinable something which we all feel, but which we don't know. To me, he said, God is truth and love. God is ethics and morality. God is fearlessness. God is the source of light and life. And yet, he is above and beyond all these. God is conscience. This Mahatma Gandhi said way back. Now today, I would like to discuss things in such a way that we are able to cover that what are the factors, what are the causes of unhappiness? And then while discussing those things that, I mean, those are the causes of unhappiness, I would also try to find out the solutions to it through spiritual ways, spiritual means. So the first cause of unhappiness is not knowing the cause of happiness. Not knowing the cause of happiness. We all want to be happy. But we are absolutely blank in finding the ways that will make us happier. The source of happiness is not known to us. We are absolutely clueless about what can make us happy. Laurie Santos of University of Yale has very clearly said that this situation is called miswanting. We do not know that what will give us happiness. Sometimes we crave for money, qualification, job, you know, marriage. But we keep trying and then we see that, no, this job is not giving me as much happiness and it is fading away. Maybe that an act of kindness is giving you more happiness than having possession of wealth. So this is first reason that we often miswant. What we should want, we don't know. And therefore, we do not get happiness. So this is the first cause of unhappiness, that we miswant. Okay. And for details, you can see Laurie Santos on the Google. She is there from University of Yale. Second is self-alienation. We have lost touch with a self. And without self-knowledge, you cannot be stable within. You will constantly go to object to change your mood or feed your senses. Always looking outward for certain things that will make that will change your mood or your, get you happiness. And objects at the same time are changing faster than your mind. You know, once you get a particular mobile, very soon you find another model of that. All gadgets, everything, every car, every model. The objects are changing faster than the change in your mood. Always turning outward for anything and not turning inward. That what actually I want. We are never need-based. We are always greed-based. Outward-based, not inward-based. And that is why spiritual knowledge appears to us as the theory or as a philosophy. Okay. We think that it is not going to get us happiness. It is something, a bookish knowledge. And therefore, we always try to see things other than this. Okay. Now, spiritual knowledge, spiritual awareness will remain abstract, will remain a theory, a philosophy, a good philosophy, until we practice it in our day-to-day life and until we apply it in our daily life. An example, a professor went to a Zen master, Zen philosophy, you know, and he said that his mind is clouded and he wants some relief. He wants to know what is Zen so that he is able to ease out. Now that Zen master asked him to sit down. Okay, take a chair, please sit down and have a cup of tea, he insisted. And while pouring tea into the cup, you know, the tea started, you know, flowing out of the cup. And then the professor said that, well, what are you doing? The tea is coming out of the cup. Then he said, this is the mental state of yours. The cup is full. How can I pour in any knowledge, piece of knowledge into it? Kindly empty your mind. Then only you will be able to understand Zen. Okay? So this is the situation that how can we, you know, think of something for which we have no space in our mind. The third cause of unhappiness, error of happiness thinking, knowing what to do, what is right or wrong, but not being able to do, a helpless situation. Most of us know in our life, no one needs to tell us that what is right, what is wrong, what is good, what is bad. We already know it. But we are not able to practice that. This is the greatest, you know, obstacle. Now, in this helpless situation, how do we come out? You know, sometimes what happens, that early age trauma, a kind of trauma or stress, due to which we succumb to wrong thinking and wrong doing. A very small example I would like to tell you, a historical example. In Mahabharata, when Bhishma Pitama asked Duryodhana in the war of Mahabharata, that I had told you not to follow anything against the dharma. Had you followed the dharma, then this war-like situation won't have arisen. Then you know what Duryodhana replied. He said that, well, I know what is dharma. I know what is good and bad. He says, janami dharmam. Janami dharmam na cha me pravritti. Mujhe pata hai ki dharm kya hai, lekin meri pravritti, meri cheshta mein nahi hai wo, main kya karu. Similar, this is the situation with most of our young people. They are facing the problem of Duryodhana. Doesn't mean that the youths do not know what is right, what is wrong. But they are struggling that they are not able to apply, you know, good habits into daily life. The fourth cause of unhappiness, uncontrolled thinking. It is another major cause of unhappiness. Thoughts are extreme to your being. You cannot control it. A small story. You know, a man suddenly, you know, he lands up under a tree, and that tree was a wishful, fulfilling tree. Wishful, fulfilling tree. Kalptaru. Kalptaru ke andar wo niche baitha. Aur wo sochne laga, de kaash agar ek glass pani mil jata thanda yahan pe, to kitna achha hota. And he gets a glass of water. He drinks it. And then he thinks that if there would have been a small place where I could have, you know, taken rest, a stone appears, he sits on that. Then he thinks that, had I got some good food here? He gets food, he ate food also. Then he thinks about some entertainment. He gets that also. And then, while enjoying everything, he thinks that, oh God, if in this hour a tiger comes, then what will happen? And you know what happened? Tiger came and gulped him. That is what happens. Whatever we think, that becomes reality in future. So if we do not think rightly, how can we do right things in future? This is so simple. Lives do not create your thoughts. Your thoughts creates lives. You know? A motorboat story again, that a person was, you know, flood had come and he climbed a tree. The level of water rose and then he climbed up again, the level rose. Now some people passing by, they said, "Ki, what are you doing? Come down, we are running out. We are running away from this place." He said, "No, no, I would be here." And further, a motorboat came. And the motorboat person said that, "Please come. We have come to rescue you." He said, "No, no, let me be here. I'm a spiritual man. God will save me." And then finally a helicopter came and with a rope, the helicopter wanted to rescue him. He was at the very top of the tree. And then also he said, "No, no, I don't need it." And finally what happened? He was drawn. Now he says, "Oh God, you did not save me. I was such a spiritual person, but you never saved me." The God replied, "Well, I gave you 3 chances, gentlemen. You did not take those opportunities, those chances. Fault lies on you and not me." So what I mean is that, you know, when we come to know of the causes of unhappiness, then we should think of, you know, what are the ways through which we can come out of that. Okay, and the spirituality is one thing, and spirituality is, you know, when you build personal relationship with God, you are spiritual and you are happier. Well, I think this is all about spirituality, how it helps you to overcome the causes which deters, which obstructs your happiness, and to powerful spiritual veins like meditation, prayer, and so many things. You know, you can overcome these obstacles. Okay, Sanskriti, back to you. So I'm done.
Okay, sir. So, all right. So before I take up questions from our participants, I would just like to ask a couple of few questions from you, sir, if you allow me to. So, yes, sir. So, sir, you are now a full professor of commerce, and you taught me economics also in BCom honors. So now you're teaching about happiness. So I would just like to exactly know, what is your purpose of purpose and meaning of life?
A very personal question indeed. But let me try to answer that question. Well, I remember a particular talk, a TED talk. The person in the TED talk was Sandeep Gupta or something. A United States-based person, of course an Indian, a venture capitalist. And then, you know, similar question was asked to him, that what is your purpose and what is the meaning of life. Then he said that, you know, I have two little daughters, and in the morning, I am in a playful mood. And so I asked them, what is your purpose of life? Then they said, my purpose is to find a gift from you every day. Okay. Amusingly, he asked, and what is your meaning of life? They said, to give it away, to give the gift away. So he laughed, and he was reminded of Picasso also. He also said that the purpose of life is to find gift, and the meaning of life is to give it away. Well, when I heard that, then I started thinking about myself also, that, I mean, what is my purpose of life? And then instantly it came to my mind that for the last 30 years or so, I have been going for nature walk invariably for hours together in the morning. I must be liking that, then only I'm continuing for so long. And then I thought that perhaps my purpose of life is admiring beauty of nature, including human. Communicating with the nature and appreciating its beauty. That, I think, is the purpose. And so far as meaning is concerned, adding something to the nature, to the beauty of nature, and of course, adding some happiness to the human beings. I think that gives me a meaning of life. I think I answered my question.
That's so wonderful, sir. And I will definitely try and at least follow some of it so that I also get to learn my purpose and meaning of life. Okay, so sir, you also talked about these spiritual values, but I just want to know again, what is its direct role in happiness?
Direct role in happiness. Okay, very good question. You know what happens, that the art of letting it go is very important. Otherwise, what happens, that, you know, whatever hurt, you know, everyone's life, there is a hurt, you know, the past. And the past, if you allow it to overpower you, then it stops your growth. It will not let you grow. Okay, it's very important to forget and forgive. Okay. And the how, unless you forget and forgive, you cannot move on in life. So through spirituality only, when you are connected to a bigger source, the source of your creation, the source of your creation, then these things appear very small to you. So you are readily, you know, readily you are able to forgive and forget also. A very important thing. And, you know, I had in the, my last class, I had explained that forgive is giving and forget is getting. Unless you give, you cannot get. And you give up lower values and you get higher values. You get love and affection if you forgive people. Okay. So these were the things.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So, sir, just now in your answer, you just mentioned about the source of creation. So I just want to ask, how do we really connect with the source of creation, source of our creation?
Oh, Sanskriti, wonderful. Very grounded question and very important question. Well, you know, I read in the newspaper itself, Swami Chidanand Saraswati. And he wrote a beautiful article in Times of India. And there he says that just as the body needs sleep each day in order to be fresh, healthy, and productive, so we also need to give time to our spirit to rest, withdraw, and reconnect with the source. Okay. To cut short, I would say meditation, silence, prayer are all ways in which our spirit reconnects with the source and draws energy and inspiration. Okay. So you can see a great purpose in this, that you draw immense energy. Okay. And that is why, you know, you connect yourself to the source, then your energy level is high, you have positive thinking, and you know, and you have the right purpose, the truth of life before you, and you have a realization, and you reach, you know, beyond the transient. Okay, so such things, the realization part, okay, and you know, your thinking becoming positive, all such things happen only when you try to connect to your source and draw energy and excitement from there, and then you are back in the day hours with full of energy and you know with full of happiness.
That's wonderful, sir. That's wonderful. All right, just one last question, sir. So I remember once you discussed about the core values. So I always wanted to ask you that, how to know what our core values are?
Yeah, I remember earlier also someone asked this question, that values, regarding values. You know, values are very simple, that, I mean, what are your, whatever is your expectation from your friends, whatever you appreciate in your friends and relatives and everything, the qualities in them, basically those are nothing but your values, your own values, okay, to which you look up to and you appreciate.
Yes, sir.
You know what happens, that when you tune out or mute the external expectations and obligations and opinions, you begin listening to yourself. And then the external noise and the inner voice, you are able to create distinction between that, your inner voice and external noise. In between the two, there is a silence, there is a space. The space created in between the two, noise and voice, noise of outside, voice of inside. There, if you concentrate, you will come to know of your core values. Okay, what is your core values? So there is a way out of everything, provided we are mindful of it, we are conscious of it. And as in the beginning, I told you, God is nothing but consciousness. I fully agree with Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so that's how.
Thank you so much, sir. So that was really, really good. And thank you for answering my question so patiently. All right. So everyone, the stage is now open for Q&A. If you want to ask any queries from Mishra sir, you may please ask your queries. Or else if you want to share something or your experience, you may please go ahead and share that.
Good evening, sir. Monica here.
Okay. Please.
So post-COVID, what happened? I work as a nature in an organization. And there were approximately, I would say that 3,000 workers in my factory and close to 600 staff members in my factory. The first wave which we saw started in January when we started hearing about the news in China. And we got an idea that the factories, the work is going to get suffer. I think the preparation started then onwards. We were getting a lot of imports of material from China. So our obviously imports stopped there. And the business started affected in the month of January 2020. Post then, March was a time when the lockdown started. We started, however, started working with minimal strength from April because we were to mask manufacturing also to support the people across. Jo hamare aas paas trade network mein the, police karmchari keh lijiye, aas paas ke zone mein, so that we do something for the society. And yet at the same time, we contribute with the workers for their salaries. Slow and steady, I think we tried and pick up, but ultimately, the time I had about recently, I think my factory workers have been asked to leave because of the financial crisis and bankers not giving funds and everything. As an HR, the only point is that there are workers, there are employees who are looking forward for job opportunities. Or aap, as an employer, you cannot support it. So, you know, ek hai ki aapki ichha bahut hai ki hame acha karna hai. Aur aapki government norms, aapki actual situation, financial situation, aapko wo support nahi karne deti hai. A lot of, I think, unrest happens in our mind. There are very few staff members who are working currently. And we're just trying to make sure that new orders are coming. You know, we have another people, you know, push our people back to jobs. Ki wo wapis aaye kaam kare. I think I've seen this journey of, you know, causes of unhappiness. Jahan pe situation aayi ki COVID aane wala hai, wahan se jo anxieties shuru hui, se leke loss of jobs, loss of family members, puri jo chain thi, and now losing out completely out of it. I think some point of time COVID has, you know, brought us to a very unhappy level because of the external environment and the situations. How do you tackle them? Because aap internal peace bhi rakh loge, spirituality se bhi connect kar loge, your needs are not being fulfilled, your family needs are not being fulfilled, aapka rent chal raha hai, ghar mein khana lana hai, you know, situation is that मैं कितना भी एक लेवल पे जाके ट्रेनिंग कर चुके थे, सब पे बहुत अच्छे लेवल पे लाए थे, सब बहुत अच्छा सोचते थे, पॉजिटिव एनवायरनमेंट, एंड नाउ आई एम सिटिंग अलोन इन माय ऑफिस विद हार्डली फ्यू पीपल वर्किंग, आई विल नेवर बी एबल टू कनेक्ट, आई विल नेवर बी एबल टू कनेक्ट बिकॉज दिस सिचुएशन हैज टू बिकम पॉजिटिव विद लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ चेंजेस. ये दो साल का जो गैप है वो हमें कम से कम 10 साल या 15 साल पीछे ले चुका है. एंड आई थिंक इनकी जो फैमिलीज थी, जो सपोर्ट सिस्टम था, इट हैज कोलैप्स कंप्लीटली. जब कोई कॉल करता है कि मैम मुझे एफएनएफ चाहिए, मेरे पास एक एम्प्लॉय नहीं है, मेरे पास बहुत है. एंड आई हैव टू एड्रेस दैट कन्वर्सेशन टू देम कि वी आर अरेंजिंग फंड्स थ्रू बैंक्स, जिस दिन पॉसिबिलिटी होती है वी विल कम बैक टू यू. We'll be making sure पहले सबसे पहले आपको release होता है. And I think COVID के बाद सबसे पहले as an organization my management was so brilliant sir. हमने free lunch work करा. Just दिन से हमने factory शुरू करी post COVID till August 31st free lunch for all workers throughout in the company. Then we started across snacks हमने December 31st तक दिए ताकि किसी को tension नहीं रहे. मैं काम पे आ गया हूँ पर मेरा खाने का क्या होगा? That situation was being tackled. बट वो एक लेवल है, यू नो, आप कंट्रीब्यूट करना चाह रहे हो, आप कर भी रहे हो, बट आज बहुत डिससैटिस्फैक्शन, चाहे वो कहो आप सेल्फ से कहो, चाहे आप कहो वर्क पर्सपेक्टिव कहो. सो मेनी टाइम्स यू हियर फ्रॉम एम्प्लॉई स्टेटिंग माय फैमिली मेंबर हैज अ वेरी मेजर मेडिकल इशू और आप प्लीज फंड्स रिलीज कर दीजिए. जहाँ हो सकता है वहाँ पे सब करते हैं, बट देन व्हेन द फाइनेंसिस आर नॉट देयर यू कैन नॉट डू इट. आई थिंक दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू नो दिस द कॉज ऑफ अनहैप्पीनेस majorly gets driven by the external factors. And I am stating this today only for the reason that beyond us as individuals, I think it's been that we've been only talking about how many of us have to take care of others. Agar hum wo nahi connect kar paate, how do we take it up?
Well, Monica, before I comment on this, I would like to acknowledge that you are emotionally very rich. Some people are financially rich, you are emotionally rich. And that is why you are so sensitive and you could be of immense help to so many people. Because of having such people only, you know, we could save so many lives. I don't want to comment upon the negligence of doctor who were responsible for the death of so many. But people like you, who were so sensitive, they were of immense help in such situation. Now let me tell you the role of spirituality here. One is dependence and another is independence. Spirituality empowers you to be independent, in plus dependent, not dependent on external forces. Okay. That is why even during Corona, many people had the chance to come out of their houses and serve people. And even economically, they were of much use. You know, and they made a lot of money also, and a lot of startups came out. Okay, so we need to listen to the wisdom of our own body, which we don't. Those who are not spiritual, they are always externally guided. They look for help and such and such, but they don't try to look within. That at that particular moment, what is the need? For example, somebody tells you to use mask 24 hours. Don't you see that you need fresh air also? The oxygen level is coming down. And the government is suggesting foolishly. And people are obeying foolishly because they don't listen to their own wisdom that what is the requirement. And when you don't listen to the wisdom of your body, then you know you obviously eat whatever out of greed, anything you know that is freely available, sweets, having not thinking that do I need it? Do my body need this? That is not the basis of choice. It is that just because you are liking your lips, you are liking it, you are having it. This is not the way. So. In difficult times also, if those spiritual people, you know, and you can just see that all these Baba Ramdevs and all these places, they were least affected. Humanization, I mean, developing immunity, okay? And all those tactics of yoga and pranayama, which is building your immunity. You don't have faith on those things. You have just faith on science and technology, medicine, etc. Okay. At times, you can take help of that also. But what is your duty? Your duty is take care of your body. I mean, try to build your immunity and have right kind of food and health and all these things. Many people said that those who went to the hospital, dependent upon the hospital, and in the hospital study for 2 days, no doctor is coming. No doctor. And this I'm telling you, not of... ordinary hospital, Gangaram Hospital, my colleague, my professor, He went there and he said, it's so terrible. For 2 days, no one came to see me, and 10 people in a hall and just one bathroom. And it was all, so unhygienic. So the situation was not, and those who said that, no, I'm sit at home. I'm not saying, I am not giving a sweeping remark, but inner strength, you know, is very important. And this inner strength you get from nowhere other than the source. Obviously, one goes to mother for getting, emotional support and everything. And similarly, you go to God, have personal relationship with him. And, even if it death occurs, death is a reality, it's the truth of life. Why should you be so scared? Human being is scared of other human being. What the hell? Earlier also, we in the family, people used to have measles and, smallpox. The mother used to, be with the side of the son, and the mother was never affected with this thing. So these are the things if we ponder, then I think, I'm not able to tell for everyone, but with those kinds of beliefs, I never had any problem. And I shouldn't say this, but for the last 40 years or so, I have not visited a single doctor. 40 years is not a small period. So having, alignment with nature and, and have faith inside, faith within and outside, love, friendship, all these things matter a lot. And due to those things only, you were of so much of help to so many people. And that must be a great source of satisfaction for you. And that will remain a source of satisfaction for you. That yes, you led a meaningful life. Not a scared fellow that, why should I help? And a selfish, highly selfish, that I might catch the same disease. Okay, you should be careful. But at the same time, you should have concern also for humanity. I have answered your question, but I really appreciate your concern. And, this is also a kind of sensitization to all of us that we must be caring and give care for others.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Monica. Thank you for sharing what you feel. And anybody else wants to ask any query? All right. So we can then just end today's lecture. So would you want to say something? Or
hello?
Yeah, Nitin.
Yes, sir? Nitin. हेलो सर.
यस
जी सर. नमस्कार.
नमस्कार. नमस्कार
जी सर. आपने ये बताया था अभी ये दुर्योधन जब कहते हैं कि मतलब धर्म मैं जानता तो हूँ लेकिन मेरी प्रवृत्ति अलग है, मेरा जो नेचर है वो डिफरेंट है, धर्म को मैं जानता तो हूँ. तो हम यहाँ मतलब धर्म को कैसे परिभाषित करेंगे, ये क्वेश्चन है. मतलब धर्म मीन्स वॉट.
You know, what happens in that even in Gita, even in Bhagavad Gita, it is said, 8th adhyay mein ya kisi mein likha hua hai, ki ant kaal mein bhi agar aap Ishwar ka dhyan karte hain, aap marnasan mein ho, aur Ishwar ka agar aap dhyan karte ho, to saaf sab saja maaf hai aap. This is the, saying of Bhagavad Gita. I am not saying. Now the question arises. How would you remember at the last moment God? Only those who have been practicing it before, they can only remember him. This is the point to be learned. Okay. So dharma needs to be practiced. Then only, you can be called as ardent follower of dharma. Okay. Otherwise, just knowing something doesn't, I give you an example of Ravana. A wizard, okay? There was no parallel to his knowledge, okay? But pravritti jo hai, wo usme nahi thi. Jiske wajah se usse pareshani. You tell me, you are a teacher. हमारे बच्चे जो हैं क्या ये जानते नहीं है कि क्या अच्छा है क्या बुरा है?
बिल्कुल सर,
वो बिल्कुल जानते हैं, इस बात को हमें बताने की जरूरत नहीं है। हाँ, लेकिन चूंकि उनको बचपन से माँ बाप ने ये आदत नहीं दिलवाई, तो उनकी चेष्टा अलग हो गई, उनकी प्रवृत्ति अलग हो गई, एंड दे आर स्ट्रगलिंग हाउ टू ओवरकम दैट। ओके, सो इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ आवर टीचर्स टू टेल देम कि बेटा ऐसे करोगे तो शायद तुम जो चीज चाहते हो उसको उसको पूरा कर पाओगे।
सही, बिल्कुल सर, थैंक यू सर।
All right, so that was a wonderful Q&A session, and thank you so much, sir, for answering all the queries so patiently. Okay, so
thanks all the participants.
Yeah, thank you everyone. So we can now just end the session, and we'll meet you all in the next session. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.